Alright, next we will be setting up the company profile. When first logging in, the system will prompt our first time setup wizard. I would recommend filling up the information, which is asterisk. Once you're done, click save and continue and you'll proceed to bank account. So this is where we keep the information of your company banks that uses to pay out employee salary and payments. You may create more than one bank account as well. After that's done, click save and continue and update your allowances. So we do provide some basic allowances available like allowance, attendance allowance, educations and all that. You can create your own allowance as well. Fill in the code, description, and you can even select exemption rule, tax payable or not. Once that's done, we go over to deductions. Similarly, you can create your own deductions and set up formula as well. Finally, you may create a calendar. So this is just a basic setup. We do have a more comprehensive calendar setup later. So you may select the rest days. So for example, we have every Saturday, every Sunday, it's a rest day. So save and continue. Finally, this is where you import your employees' information. You may download our Excel spreadsheet, fill it up with the information required, and submit back to the system. And we are done with our setup wizard. Click Do Not Show again and close. Now, next we can go over to our company profile to fill up additional information. Tools, company profile. So on this page, you will be able to fill up the information like your phone, nature of business. This information is important because it will show up in your government reports like EPF, social reports and all that. You are also required to fill up your HRDF contribution percentage, if any. Next, we go over to company address. So this is where you update your company address and also the contact person information. Like I mentioned, this will show up in our government reports. So normally, this will be the HR contact information. Finally, go over to statutory information to fill up the company's EPF number, the branch address. Same goes for SOCSO and your tax information. And if you have any bank accounts you want to edit or adjust the information, go over to bank accounts and you may view, edit or add on different banks. Just for example, I may choose Malaysian Banking Bank, Maybank. Key in my account number, choose the bank state branch, and if there is any other information that is required, click on other information. And as you can see, for M2E, you need to create your corporate code here. M2E, you need to key in your client batch ID. Or MAS, you need to create your originator ID here. So get the information from your respective banks and provide here. Click on save and that's done. Alright, finally, once you're done editing the information here, remember to click on the save on the top right button. And that's it for company profile setup.